A'uzu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Surah Al-Masad, background. This is the only place in the Quran where a person has been condemned by name. Abu Lahab was the real uncle of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. As per the Arab traditions, an uncle represented the father, especially when the nephew was fatherless. But this man, in his hostility to Islam, trampled over all of Arab traditions and did his utmost to cause hardship and pain to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Before the proclamation of prophethood, two of the Prophet's daughters were married to two of Abu Lahab's sons. When the Prophet began inviting people to Islam, Abu Lahab forced his sons to divorce both the Prophet's daughters. Whenever the Prophet ﷺ went to preach Islam, Abu Lahab would follow him, telling the people that he is a liar and throwing stones at him until his heels bled. Then in the seventh year of prophethood, when all the clans of Quraysh boycotted the Prophet ﷺ socially and economically, the Prophet's clans of Bani Hashim and Bani al-Muttalib remained steadfast in his support and stayed with him in the outskirts of Mecca. But Abu Lahab was the only person who sided with the disbelieving Quraysh against his own clan. Not only that, when some starving people from his own clan would come to the Mecca markets to buy food, Abu Lahab would call out to the merchants to demand a forbidding price, telling them that he would make up for any loss that they incurred. On account of such misdeeds, Abu Lahab was condemned by name in this surah. Surah Al-Masad. Perish be the hands of Abu Lahab, and perish be he. His wealth and whatever he earned, that is his children, shall not avail him anything. Soon he shall be burnt in a flaming fire, and his wife, the carrier of firewood. She used to put thorns in the Prophet's path and slander him, shall have a rope of palm leaf fiber around her neck.